Bob from Chicago. It's good to be back in Belgium. Thank you for coming out tonight. I need a little more guitar and a little less vocals. This one's off the Grim Scary Tales album. Song about a Roman emperor. He would kill guys on the street when he was a young man and throw their bodies in the sewers. When he became emperor of Rome, he would dress as wild animals, biting off people's genitals who were tied to stakes, unable to defend themselves. He burned Christians for his light at his wedding, and he tore his mother's womb out to see where he came from. This one's about Nero Caesar. It's called Nero's Inferno. Jeffrey's morbid childhood. He would pick up roadkill, dead dogs, cats, squirrels, raccoons, whatever he could find. He would take home the carcasses and do experiments on them. He would also keep the intestines of the dogs in jars. There's a song called Dog Guts. We'll be right back. Thank you. A little more guitar, just a touch. Close off Bloom. 1989 we did this one. Talk about this guy from Chicago who had a place called the Black Hotel where he killed over 200 people. He would melt their flesh from their bones and sell their skeletons to medical students. It's about Herman Mudgett. So it's called Dr. Holmes. I'm going on the rise again. I'm going on the rise again. From the rise again. Now feel that Dr. Holmes door. First album. 1986 we did this one. We've been together since 81 as musicians, but Macabre started in 1985. So we've been the same three guys ever since. Imagine that. We have Dennis Simonis on the drums, Nefarious on bass and vocals, and the corporate death on guitar and vocals. This was our Grim Reality. I got 36 different states in 4 different countries. My victims never knew what was going to happen to them. I've had strangulations, knifings, beatings, and actual crucifixions of humans. All around the world, there's people just like me set out to take human life. It's about Henry Lee Lucas and Otis Tool. It's called Serial Killer.
Everybody part. Hey, yeah. Late at night, the training day.
From Scary Tales. Talk about a very bloody, morbid family. They built a little shack, a shanty. And people would come there for the night. But they would be killed once they were inside. They would be hit over the head with a sledgehammer. Their throats cut for good measures. They would be robbed of all their valuables and clothing and buried near the shack in Kansas City. It's about a very bloody, morbid family. It's called the Bloody Benders. Different ways. Cyanide spray to the face was his favorite method, but he also used guns, knives, and ropes to kill his victims. And his family back home knew little about his real job being a mafia hitman. It's about Richard Kuklinski. It's called the Iceman. And he wasn't a very nice man. Ah! Next one's up, Sinister Slaughter. Song about a man who liked to break into people's houses while they were sleeping at night. On a hot summer night, they would have the screen window down, and that kept the bugs out, but it didn't keep this guy out. He'd easily break through the screen window, sneaking up to the bed where the husband and wife were sleeping with his gun in hand. He would shoot the husband in the head, rape and beat the wife, and make her swear to Satan before killing her. It's about Richard Ramirez. It's called The Night Stalker. Jeffrey worked the late shift, the graveyard shift. And he was very tired working the strange hours. And you see, dismembering a body is a very big job. So Jeff killed this guy, too tired to cut him up. He put him in the bathtub. Then he killed another guy shortly after and put him in the bathtub too. Filled him up with cold water and disinfected to keep the smell out of it. He would drain it daily and take showers with the two dead men in his tub. So it's called Scrub-a-Dub-Dub, three men in a tub. Okay. We have time for two more songs, two more, and then we're going to pack it up and have a good time. If anyone wants to smoke any weed with us or hash, we'd be happy to do that after the show. We couldn't bring any from Chicago with us, so. So what's up, Dahmer? Talk about Jeffrey's first victim. He picked this guy up who was hitchhiking, took him home and got him drunk. When the man wanted to leave, that was the big mistake. Jeff hit him over the head with a dumbbell, strangled and dismembered him, and put him in a drain in the yard in Bath, Ohio. It's about Stephen Hicks. This was called The Hitchhiker. Sound about a German killer. guy would get orgasms. He would come when he would see his victim's blood squirt out, when he would cut them with his knives. About Peter Curtin, called the Vampire of Dusseldorf. Once again, thank you guys for hanging out this time here. I guess we don't have too many fans out here, but you guys are the real deal here.
See your blood run, that's a thing that makes me cough.